So you probably saw this coming. Now that we found probabilities, we want to be able to find the mean and the variance of a binomial distribution. Now the mean and the of the binomial distribution is simply mu equals n times pi. So for this Michelle scenario with the basketball, n was 13, pi was 0.783. So the mean, what we'd expect, is 10.1790. That means if Michelle went to the free throw line right now, took 13 shots, our best guess is that she would hit 10.1790. Now, this is kind of like the average number of children. Well, what's the average number of children? 2.3 children per household. Well, you show me the household with 2.3 kids. No, it's not going to happen. If you walked into any particular house, your best guess before walking in with an average of 2.3 would be just simply 2. Likewise here, on average, if she shot 13 again and again and again and again and again. On average, if I took how many successes she had every time she shot 13, again, on average, I expect those to average out to be 10.1790. So that's the actual average. So in reality, I would expect about 10. 9 wouldn't freak me out too much. 11 wouldn't freak me out too much. But I would expect about 10 based on this average. Now, again, for my class, I would need to see all of this. And I would expect some type of meaningful English statement to wrap it up. Now, the variance, sigma squared, is n times pi, that's the mean, times 1 minus pi. That's the probability of a failure. So this is n, the number of trials, times the probability of success, times the probability of failure. Now, again, for Michelle's scenario, this is 13 times 0.783 times 1 minus 0.783, which gives you 2.2088. And the variance is really typically not all that useful, other than it gives me what I would use more often, and that's the standard deviation. The standard deviation, as we recall from earlier chapters, simply the square root of the variance. So the standard deviation for a binomial would be the square root of n times pi times 1 minus pi. So if we find it for the scenario for Michelle, sigma equals square root of sigma squared, which is square root of all of this, which rounded is the square root of 2.2088, which gave me 1.4862. So this is the standard deviation. And you could do things with this very similar to what you could with Chebyshev's or the empirical rule with any sort of data. So if I had reason to believe that this is symmetric, I would use the empirical rule. Otherwise, I'd use Chebyshev's rule. Now, this distribution won't be very symmetric because the probability of success is 0.783. If I have 0 to 1, that means 0.5. Think of this as pi, probability of success. If I have probability of success of 0.5, then it's going to be the just probability distribution is going to be very, very symmetric. It's going to look something like this in a taper off in an extremely symmetric manner. It may go out a little bit farther, whatever. What happens is, in this scenario, probability success was 0.78. This would be 0.75. So I'm actually up here 0.78-ish like this somewhere. Oops, I don't like that color. There we go. So it would look something like this, perhaps. See, I have the possibility here of being skewed left. Here, eventually, I'm going to stop, but this way it'd be skewed left. So I'm going to end up a slightly skewed distribution. So you could actually calculate all these probabilities and create a probability histogram based on this being the pi axis, and then here, this would be a probability axis. Just like relative frequency, we did a histogram. By hand, you could have done these as relative frequency, which is a percent. Same thing here. Add up all those percents, you get one. Add up all these probabilities, you get one. So you could actually do a histogram using probabilities, and you'd see the symmetry or lack of symmetry as you changed the probabilities of success. But something else that we look at in another chapter is kind of cool. As n increases, when A starts getting really big, then what happens is we're going to end up with a situation where I will still get symmetry. About, heck, I could be up here like 0.95 or something. And for large enough N, I would still have a very tight symmetric sort of a distribution there.